your brother!
Understand these poems.
Well, there's always meaning if you look hard enough, brother. It's all. And what you bring to it.
Whatever this thing is, I think the animal's inside.
Whatever's inside is kicking up quite a bit of sand.
How do we reach it?
There's caves and tunnels aplenty out here. Let's find one and see where it takes us.
Ugh!
What's that?
A diagram for a sword hilt.
Perhaps we should show it. To one of the dwarves. They'll know what to do with it.
So much sand. I don't think we're getting through that gate in this storm.
Not getting up there with all this sand in your way.
Yuck.
A tempting treasure chest! Damn the sand!
Extends underneath the desert. Is the creature within?
Yeah, sounds like it. We'll find it if we keep going. What is this place?
A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining now that they're barred from the temple.
Great. Considering what happened the last time we were in Alphar, can you really blame them?
Patience. A virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader. You heard. What does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... I feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I am curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay.
Hmm.
coming!
Yaffa!
Talk to animals or enchanted rings or whatever.
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you'd help some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want too. To abandon it. But if we have to kill a bunch of dark elves to get there...
I remember a young lad whom, until this very moment, would take on an army of Draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not repeating the same mistakes. Getting involved where we shouldn't.
Why does it feel like no matter what we do in Alphine, we wind up hurting Dark Elves?
We are down here to help the creature you hurt.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
No.
Okay. Ah!
Bloody half goof I've ever laid eyes on.
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the song of the sands. We don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lynch. Get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last squid thingy we saw was Diener, so...
Oh, boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that, little brother, is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners. There's gotta be a way to clear those rocks. Get a better angle. Get out.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Half-gifers are known to burrow, so I'd hesitate to place full blame on our dark elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the Dark Elves, any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources, one the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the Hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this Hive, are we hurting Dark Elves?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free it.
This is the spot! We can cut the half Koopa loose here. It flies?
Of course it flies. It's a half Koopa.
Sounds much happier now. And hey, the storm's gone.
Aye. Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered? He just wants to spend time with you, lad, while he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead, but if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing it. Out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
Remember to ask Tyr about his travels to the lands beyond the seas.
You wish to travel the world?
I don't know. Maybe. See new places. Find out more about myself.
More bloody
droppers.
Reminds me of tales of a cruel empress, one too angry to die.
We will see.
Brother, I had a thought. What if we took a stealthy approach to our next battle?
No.
Should we get back to listing all the awful deeds of the Aesir god? Oh, I know. There was Skavi, the queen of the hunt.
Aye, she spurned Odin's affections, so he tricked her into killing her father.
There was Starkather the Mighty, the Jotnar military leader.
Slandered by Odin, tricked and murdered by Thor.
And there was Thrym the Cunning, the giant king who stole Thor's hammer.
Odin traded him Freyr to get it back, then sent Thor in disguise to murder his entire court.
Hold. We will finish later.
Sort of a harp. I can play beautifully, you know.
I do not, and would prefer it remain.
We fought in Svartalfheim. Those were Anriar? I thought Anriar were just spirits and... Valhalla until Ragnarok comes.
They were no spirits.
Indeed, brother. Odin appears to have found a loophole. Activated his forces early as a standing army. Perhaps something he could only do without any honest Valkyries around to stand in his way.
Any more Thor and Odin stories to remember? Who else? Ah, Hrungnir the Brawler, the stone giant.
Aye, mocked by Odin, murdered by Thor.
Enough of this.
But there's more.
I do not care. War with Odin is not the answer.
My face is itchy. I think my beard's coming in.
Is it?
Yeah, on my jawline. See? It's growing.
Is it?
That's not just dirt.
It's not dirt.
What do you think it means?
seen more raiders come back as Hellwalkers lately. I thought freeing the Valkyrie Queen was supposed to restore balance to the realms, and keep that from happening.
That's a good question, lad. And a troubling one. If Hell's filled up again, it suggests that something's been hindering Sigrun's efforts. Or perhaps something even more urgent is keeping her distracted and unable to visit. Even occasionally.
Yeah. Sorry, Mimir. There's something I'm not sure I quite understand. In the Ragnarok prophecy, Odin knows, all the realms get destroyed, including Asgard. In the version Groa kept secret, Asgard still falls. Wouldn't Odin have tried to prevent it either way? What difference did her lie really make?
Let this wait. Stay alert.
What about your son? What'll it be? Have we more to talk about? What can I make for you? Oh, got time to chat? Lovely crystal work and those elven gifts you found. I'll be happy to pay.
Well, I hope Tyr's had enough time to find his equilibrium, or whatever.
Indeed. I saw flashes of the old god of war in him, but they were fleeting.
There is nothing wrong with opposing war, nor opposing prophecy.
I suppose that's fair. Never can be quite sure what the Giants meant by any of it.
Am I the only one that remembers they predicted our entire journey to Jotunheim? If the Giants saw Tyr leading armies at Ragnarok, and I believe them.
The question is how you'll ever make Tyr believe it.
Master Kratos, I would speak with you.
Speak.
If you are ever in need of my services and I am not present, I have installed these handy chimes for you to notify me. Simply throw your axe and strike the chime, and I will attend to your needs.
There.
Ah, you figured it out. Very well. You know how to reach me now. All that said, I'm happy to discuss anything else on your mind.
I have a question.
Splendid! I delight in offering my tutelage to the Inquisitive.
Over the ledge, by the gateway over there. I noticed these dragons.
Dragons? Oh no, young Master Atreus. Those are leaned worms, the brood of Nidhogg.
Nidhogg? That's the mother?
Correct. She's also a vital piece of the Yggdrasilian circle of life, as it were. I tend the branches up here, while Nidhogg chews the roots from below to prevent overgrowth. A delicate balance.
So they're friendly?
Well, they're not nearly so affable as myself, but there's no reason to expect hostility so long as they're left in peace. Nidhogg is a stern matriarch, as protective of her offspring as she is determined to teach them proper discipline.
That sounds
familiar.
Well, I mustn't keep you further from your goings-on.
Hi, take the hint.
Go away!
glad to see you back, young one. Come help me, won't you?
Oh, sure.
We can eat whenever you like, Kratos. The stew will only improve with time.
Glad you're in a better mood.
Yes. I was a little overwhelmed.
Dress. Eat.
Oh, careful. Careful.
Thank you. Enjoy. Enjoy, my friends.
Yeah. We'll see about that.
Here you are. A meal fit for a champion.
Enough. I said we would speak no more of that.
Yes, of course. Didn't mean to offend.
I'm not offended. It's just a word.
The word didn't cloud your judgment.
So, you really don't think it means anything? After the journey Mom sent us on?